Hi guys, my name is Rajveer and welcome to NFI online tutorials on VFD. VFD is variable frequency drive. So in this video, we are going to see a basic overview of what is a VFD, what are the different terminals, how to connect your motor to a VFD. So these are the couple of slides which I'm going to use to explain. This is the video demonstration. That's the drive. That's how a VFD looks like. Okay. That's the three-phase induction motor, which is connected to the drive using this wire over there. This is the keypad display, and that's the input power supply which I'm giving to the drive, which is 220 volts single phase. Okay, that's the frequency display as of now. This is how our drive setup look like. Now the drive which I'm using here is 1.5 kilowatt of Delta. Okay, so this is M series 2HV drive, all right, which says input of 230 volts 1/3 phase. Now this means the input of this drive, the input which is coming here, that should be 230 volts. It can be single phase or it can be three phase. You can see here L1, L2, L3. Because in some countries we have 230 volts as three phase, in some countries we have 440 volts and three phase. So in my country we have single phase as 230 volt and three phase as 440 volts. So I have applied a single phase of 230 volts to this drive. So this drive will give the output of 230 volts three phase. That's the drive configurations. So that three phase output is going from this wire to this motor. All right. So if you want to see in the diagram, how does it look like? It's like that. This is a diagram representation of a drive. These are the input terminals. So I have connected line neutral, and these are the two contacts of a relay. You can also take a contactor if you have a three phase supply. So that's the coil which I'm using. This is the push button. NO, this is NC, that's the coil, that's how I have flashed this coil, and these are the contacts of this coil. So what happens when you press this A, this will be latched, and this will start giving supply line and neutral to your drive, and this will unlatch. So these two push buttons can be used as a latching and unlatching to start and stop the drive, like that. Okay, that's how, these are diagrammatic explanations in that. Okay, so in this drive, I'm not using this start stop switch. Besides, I'm using this MCB to start and stop my drive. This is an MCB. Okay, this is giving a line neutral signals to my drive here. Okay, let's go back to this angle. All right, so let's see the first slide, which says VFD status screens. We have different status on the drive. Now VFD is used to control the frequency. Okay, if you see here, it says motor RPM is equivalent to 120 F by P. This F, this is a factor frequency, which says it's directly proportional to the motor RPM. So what does it mean if your frequency is, let's say, 50 Hertz? Okay, generally motor runs at 50 Hertz frequency. In few countries, it's 60 Hertz. Let's talk about 50 Hertz. At 50 Hertz, the maximum RPM is 3000 RPM. Okay, so at 25 Hertz, RPM will be 1500, because these are proportional. These are directly proportional. So let's see the status screen. The first screen talks about motor is off, because you can see this red LED here. The same LED you'll find here, which says motor is off. Okay, and this is the frequency. This is the command frequency, which we command from the drive. Okay, so that's the command frequency. Then you have output frequency denoted by H. So if I press this mode here, you will find H. Right now H is zero because motor is off. So output frequency is zero. Then you have parameters by P, direction as forward, ampere as A. So if I press mode again, this is the ampere right now, which is 0 ampere, motor will stop. This is the direction. This is the internal counter value, which you can change as well. I'll show you in the later slide. This is the command frequency. So these two switches, green and red, these are the run and stop switch. So when I press run, your motor will start running, you can see here. And that's the command frequency. In this case, this is the output frequency. So if I stop the motor, you'll find frequency is decreasing, going back to zero. When I run the motor, frequency will increase up to the command frequency, 12.2, which is over here, 12.2. Now in that case, your current has been increased to 0.1 ampere. So here you will find the status of your drive, of your motor, what's all happening there. Okay, so let's move ahead. Now we have different terminals. These are the control terminals, which you will find over here, these terminals. We have this highlighted view of these terminals here. So it says relay feedback, RA, RB and RC. These are the three terminals by which we can have feedback from the drive. Now feedback can be in various cases. For example, when your drive is running, this can give you a feedback. When your drive is stopped, this can give you a feedback. When your drive has attained maximum frequency or some desired frequency, or if there is any fault, this can give us the feedback. So these are the feedback terminals. One more pair is there, MCM and MO1. These are the feedback as well. So you have two feedback terminals, RA, RB, RC, MCM and MOI. All right, MO1. And these are the control terminals from M0 to ground. Now these control terminals are used to control the frequency in steps, to control the operation, start, stop, directions, its different step speeds, jog operation. You can control from here. One way is to control this motor from here, from start and stop. This is the control mode from the keypad. But if you want to have external start and stop, let's say from this panel which is here, you can do that by selecting your control panel on these terminals, which is M0 to M5. Okay. Then you have one AFM. This is analog frequency meter. It's a feedback which you'll get based on 0 to 10 volts. If the frequency is 0 hertz, you can get 0 volt feedback. If frequency is 50 hertz, you'll get 10 volt feedback. So that's the feedback proportional to the frequency. This can be proportional to current as well by changing the parameter. So that's the feedback which you can read in your PLC or in your HMI, and you can display that on your screen for the monitoring purpose. Then you have ACI and AVI, which is analog current input, analog voltage input. These are the two sources by which you can change the frequency of your drive by this range. By current of 4 to 20 milliampere, you can change the frequency from 0 to 50. You can change that. Okay, this is a source of frequency terminal. And if you are having a voltage source of 0 to 10 volts, still you can change the frequency by applying the voltage at AVI. These are the two frequency control terminals. This is plus 10 volt internal power supply. Ground is the common of this drive. And these MCM and MOI, MO1 is the output feedback terminal, as I showed you. So I have also made this terminals over here from M0 to M5. So what I have done is I have connected these terminals to the PLC. If you see here, we can analyze this diagram. This is the output card of PLC. Okay. So M0 is connected to out 0, M1 to out 1, similarly up to M5 to out 5. And this ground is connected to common. I'll tell you what are the funda behind that. Fundamental is when you connect ground to your M0, M0 get active. So we can perform functions with M0, M1, M2, M3, M4 up to M5 if you connect ground to this any of this terminal. So what I'm doing here is if I turn on my Y0 from the PLC, this ground will travel from common to out 0. You will understand what I'm talking about if you have seen my earlier videos of PLC. What happens when you turn on the outputs? Ground gets shorted to your output terminal. Okay, so this M0 will get the ground and Y0 is on. M1 will get the ground when Y1 is on, and so on. Okay, so this is I have already made the connections, and this ACI and AVI and this 10 volts and ground, these can be used to change the frequency. So right now my terminals are connected like this is my D2A card, channel 2 is going to my ACI. You can use AVI terminal as well if you use here V+. So analog voltage, this channel 2 is the channel 2 of D2A card, which is digital to analog card. So channel 2 is connected to AVI. So I'll be giving voltage from this channel to control the frequency of my drive. Okay, and this is the, if you see here, AFM and ground, this is connected to channel 2 of A to D card, which is analog to digital. This is to monitor the feedback of your drive in your PLC. So this is already linked with the PLC in the panel. And if you want to see a little look, so over there, find a PLC and analog cards which are connected to the drive. The signal from there is coming to this drive by these terminal blocks right here. This is how I have extended the supply of the drive. This is going top to the PLC. That's how my drive is connected. All right, so we have already made these terminals. Next is we have motor output terminals coming from here. This is over there, you can see that three phase output coming going to the motor. Then motor brake terminals. If you're applying a brake, you need to use a brake resistance because we need to drop the back EMF voltage somewhere. So we apply resistance to the brake terminals B1 and B2. because you need to drop that voltage. So that is used for that case. Then you have inputs. These are the input terminals over there. Okay, here we have three phase or single phase 220 VAC. This is how we can give the voltage to your drive. All right. So right now drive is on. If you want to see, if I run this drive, this will start the motor and this will stop the motor. So that was about basic introduction about what are the different terminals, what are the different components of your drive and how you can use that. So in another few videos, we'll see how we can control the drive by choosing the parameters. All right. Thank you.